do it, it could break just like a bow and arrow. Many years are using sophisticated 3D computer technology to figure out just how you take down a massive mile and a half long erector set full of hazards. Now, we also have to be careful about hazardous material. The lead itself, the workers that are there around it, we have to follow proper procedures. We have to monitor blood lead levels in the blood. The whole project takes 3 years and will cost $239 million. At the Bay Bridge, Jeffrey Schaub, KCBS.
The San Francisco Zoo welcomed a new resident today that currently measures only about 4 feet long, but it's going to change in a big way.
The Komodo dragon is the largest living lizard in the world. He'll live in the trees while he's young, but then he's going to get to be 9 feet tall. That's taller than any person you know. He'll reach 160 pounds.
President and Director Tanya Peterson. The Komodo dragon is native to Indonesia, but this one comes from the zoo in Knoxville, Tennessee. They are known to eat other animals that are nearly the same size.
KCBS News Time 5:34. It's time for Dave Ross. Jim Bohannon in for him today.
How far is too far? I'm Jim Bohannon for Dave Ross from the CBS Radio Network. We're pushing that proverbial envelope again to the point of ripping it. Pope Francis says it pains him to see young priests and nuns driving flashy cars. I'm not sure what happened to that old vow of poverty, but I guess the operative question is, what would Jesus drive? And then there's Kosovo, a town you've never heard of in Siberia, but you'll likely not forget, now that we tell you it's home to the world's highest per capita vodka consumption, roughly 25 gallons of vodka per person per year, over half a pint of vodka each day. But naturally, we wonder how far is too far, most of all, about sex. Big Atlantic City casinos currently suffering 7 years of bad luck. Is it possible that the problem is too much clothing? Well, next month, the club stores from New York City will open a branch office in the Trump Taj Mahal, making it Atlantic City's first casino strip club. Or if you're a poker fan, that's rooms are better to open. Even Vegas doesn't have this yet, although they are enjoying the playful frolicking at the Act at the Palazzo Hotel Casino, in which the actors, some requiring almost no costume at all, toss condoms into the audience and simulate sex acts and bestiality on stage. The Palazzo is going to court to order that the act be packed and out of there. Well, what happens in Vegas is sometimes invited not to stay in Vegas. I think it is a sure sign that the apocalypse...